An award-winning film is hitting big screens across the U.S. Through animated illustrations, it captures a daring confrontation that happened 20 years ago between a small group of citizens and the Chinese Communist Party's propaganda machine, and the deadly consequences afterwards. The film is Canada's pick for the 2023 Oscar race. NTD sat down with the film's artist and main character, Da Xiong, to find out more.
When the ruling regime is using all its media outlets to churn out propaganda against your faith, what do you do? This is the question that an award-winning film is bringing to life in theaters across the U.S. Called Eternal Spring, it captures a true event from 20 years ago in China. That's when a group of spiritual practitioners hacked into China's state-controlled television network to counter the communist regime's propaganda against their spiritual practice, Falun Gong. Falun Gong is a spiritual meditation based on the principles of truthfulness, compassion, and tolerance. In the 90s, about one in every 13 Chinese people practiced it. But millions of them were thrown into prison and tortured after the regime launched a nationwide persecution campaign. On top of that, the regime blanketed China with hate propaganda against the practice. From national to local TV, hate-filled attacks against Falun Gong were on air 24 hours a day. The TV hijacking event took place under this context. And the film tells the story through the lens of Da Xiong, a Falun Gong practitioner who witnessed it.
Afterwards, my instinct told me that danger might be around the corner, that police raids may come tomorrow, and that's what happened.
Police raided the entire city, a population of over 9 million.
A lot of practitioners were forced to flee their homes. Many practitioners were arrested. Their homes were searched. Police arrested over 4,000 practitioners.
Da Xiong is also a renowned comic book artist. He's drawn for both the Justice League and Star Wars graphic novels. After being forced to flee China, he wanted to recreate the story.
I've drawn many American heroes, like Superman and Batman. They are superheroes in people's imaginations. But more heroes come from our ordinary lives. They faced off against the rogue communist regime with their own courage and effort. They're truly remarkable, which is why I would like to bring their stories to life.
But tracing the event was not easy. Of the hijacking's core participants, six have died at the hands of Chinese police. Of those who are still alive,
the main ones were in prison. We couldn't get any information from them.
A breakthrough came in 2017 after a survivor made out of China, following 10 years in prison.
We were only able to sort out the stories after we found a key participant, Jin Shuezhe.
The film was 6 years in the making, and the hand-drawn illustrations alone took over 2 years. But for him, that wasn't the hard part.
You have to recall the memories, those unhappy memories, painful memories while in China. It's like a scar has already healed, but you have to cut it open again and feel what it's like to be painful.
But he says his own feelings aren't important.
Because most of the people that were involved in the TV hijacking event have died. Their families fell apart. What they went through is far more cruel than what I've been through. I have a sense of mission. It's like as if I'm finishing what they have not completed. And to tell the truth to the world, this is what kept me going.
He noted tapping into state-controlled TV network proves no easy task, and the participants knew the risks and consequences.
If the police arrests don't come today, they could come tomorrow.
So why did they do it?
Those practitioners want to clarify the truth about Falun Gong and let the Chinese people know that they have a right to choose to know the truth. This is very important. No one wants prison terms. We all have families. We all have comforts in life that are hard to let go of. But since they chose to do this, that means they know the significance of doing this was bigger than their own personal feelings.
He added, it also comes down to having great love for the country.
The movie also talked about the idea of what is love. It's to have the courage to carry on the traditional values of this nation. This is the biggest love for the country, instead of staying numb and silent. But this comes down to individuals' choices. Not everyone can do something like this.
Da Xiong explained the film also gives a different big picture about China.
It showcases the deep influence that Falun Gong had left on the Chinese society. Also, how Falun Gong practitioners think about things. Why did they want to do this TV hijacking event? They have persisted against Beijing's persecution for 23 years.
The film is Canada's pick for the 2023 Oscar race. It will contest for Best International Feature. Meanwhile, the film is hitting big screens across the U.S., including New York, Los Angeles, and Washington, D.C. It also has upcoming releases in the U.K., Canada, and Australia. Juliet Song, NTD News.